this Mass is requested for the repose of the soul of James Motida on his 5th anniversary, and is requested by Eunice Motida. We thank God for what he has done for us in our lives, and we present to him all our needs. We want to pray for the sick and the aged, and for those who take care of the sick and the aged. We pray for those who have lost their loved ones, and for the souls in purgatory. We pray that God may help our economy to improve, that people may live happily and peacefully, and for communal and for the individual needs. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous faults. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. Enable us, we pray, Almighty God, to proclaim the power of the risen Lord, that we who have received the pledge of his gift may come to possess all he gives when it is fully revealed. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
First reading, One Heart and Soul, a reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The company of those who believed were of one heart and soul, and no one said that any of the things he possessed was his own, but they had everything in common. And with great power, the apostles gave their testimony to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great grace was upon them all. There was not anyone needy among them, for as many as were possessors of lands or houses sold them and brought the proceeds of what was sold and laid it at the feet of the apostles. And distribution was made to each as any had need. Thus, Joseph, who was surnamed by the apostles Barnabas, which means son of encouragement, a Levite, a native of Cyprus, sold a field which belonged to him and brought the money and laid it at the apostles' feet. The word of the Lord. The response to the psalm. The Lord is king, The Lord is king with majesty enrobed. The Lord is king with majesty enrobed. The Lord is king with majesty enrobed. The Lord has robed himself with might. He has girded himself with power. The Lord is king with majesty enrobed. The world you made firm, not to be moved. Your throne has stood firm from of old. From all eternity, O Lord, you are. The Lord is king with majesty enrobed. Truly, your decrees are to be trusted. Holiness is fitting to your house. O Lord, until the end of time. The Lord is king with majesty enrobed. Gospel acclamation. The Son of Man must be lifted up, that whoever believes in him may have eternal life.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. At that time, Jesus said to Nicodemus, "You must be born anew. The wind blows where it wills, and you hear the sound of it, but you do not know where it comes from or where it goes. So it is with everyone who is born of the Spirit." Nicodemus said to him, "How can this be?" Jesus answered him, "Are you a teacher of Israel, and yet you do not understand this? Truly, truly, I say to you, we speak of what we know and bear witness to what we have seen, but you do not receive our testimony. If I have told you you other things and you do not believe, how can you believe if I tell you heavenly things? No one has ascended into heaven but he who descended from heaven, the Son of Man. And as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, so must the Son of Man be lifted up, that whoever believes in him may have eternal life." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. My dear brothers and sisters, in our first reading, we hear how the first community of believers lived. Nobody claimed ownership of anything. Whoever had a piece of land or a house or any property, they sold and bring it to the common poor, that everybody's needs were provided for, and none of them was in any need, because all people's needs were taken care of. People sold all that they owned and brought the proceeds to the apostles to distribute to those who are in want. You can imagine how happy they were that nobody claiming to be richer than the other, that they lived equally all. And then when they met to share the word of God and to break the bread, it had a lot of meaning to them, because what made them do so is the fact that Jesus, who had come into this world to suffer and to die, and rise again that people's sins may be removed or done away with, that his love united them. And they wanted to live like Jesus, who abandoned everything that he owned, even his glory, and he owned everything, but he left everything in order to win us for God. We too are a God, not allow anything or anybody to come between us and God. We must allow God to be number one in our lives, and then he will be able to lead us, to guide us, and to shape our lives, and that we may be able to live in accordance with his own will. So that, as he taught Nicodemus, our being baptized, it will help us to live like people who have been born from above, people who know where they are coming from, where they are, and where they are headed to. Let us allow Jesus to guide us and to lead us, so that he may lead us to eternal life and to heaven. Brethren, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for the good of all his holy church. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these Paschal mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, Lord, you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him, the children of right rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are a throne open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and his rising, the life of all has risen. Therefore, overcome with the Paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with a angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim, Holy, Holy, Holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fountain of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving it thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Philip Agnoro, our Bishop, David Kamau, the auxiliary bishop, and all the clergy. Remember us, remember your servant, James Motida, whom you called from this world. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and now who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have praised you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coherent with eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day. But that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. We offer each other the sign of peace. Love of God,
have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life.
Specialis panis vivus et vitalis. My Jesus, I believe that you're present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you are already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. Hear, O Lord, our prayers, that this most holy exchange, by which you have redeemed us, may bring your help in this present life and ensure for us eternal gladness. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May the Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go forth, the Mass is ended. Alleluia, alleluia. Peace to God, alleluia, alleluia. Have a blessed day.
Same to you, Father. Number 724, stanza number 3. Ame ishinda mauti, ame mushinda shetani, aleluya. Bwana Yesu kafufuka, tumwimbie kwa Mungu.